Hello guys, I am back with some more spicy jokes, so let's start. Number 1, a man escapes from prison where he has been for 15 years. He breaks into a house to look for money and guns, and finds a young couple in bed. He orders the guy out of bed and ties him to a chair. He ties the girl to the bed and he gets on top of her, kisses her neck, and then gets up and goes into the bathroom. While he's in there, the husband tells his wife, "Listen, this guy is an escaped convict. Look at his clothes. He probably spent lots of time in jail and hasn't seen a woman in years. I saw how he kissed your neck. If he wants to, don't resist, don't complain. Do whatever he tells you. Satisfy him no matter how much he nauseates you. This guy is probably very dangerous. If he gets angry, he'll kill us. Be strong, honey. I love you." His wife responds, "He wasn't kissing my neck. He was whispering in my ear. He told me he was gay, thought you were cute, and asked me if we had any Vaseline. I told him it was in the bathroom. Be strong, honey. I love you too." Number 2, a woman was nagging her husband to cut the grass. To which the husband answered, "What do I look like to you? A landscaper?" Next time the sink was dripping, she asked him again, "Honey, can you fix the faucet?" The husband replied, "What do I look like to you? A plumber?" 2 days later, a light bulb went out and she begged him again, "Honey, can you change the light bulb?" His reply was, "What am I? An electrician?" A few days later, the husband comes home from work to find that the lawn is cut, the faucet is fixed, the light bulb is changed. Very surprised, he says, "Honey, what happened here?" The wife replies, "You know our new next-door neighbor? He came over and fixed everything." The husband says, "Honey, how did you pay him?" "Oh, you know," the wife says, "he told me that I could either bake him a cake or have sex with him." Somewhat relieved, the husband asks, "Phew, so what kind of a cake did you bake for him?" The wife replies, "Who do you think I am? Betty Crocker." Number 3, Bob was in trouble. He forgot his wedding anniversary. His wife was really angry. She told him, "Tomorrow morning, I expect to find a gift in the driveway that goes from 0 to 200 in 6 seconds, and it better be there." The next morning he got up early and left for work. When his wife woke up, she looked out the window, and sure enough, there was a box gift wrapped in the middle of the driveway. Confused, the wife put on her robe and ran out to the driveway, brought the box back in the house. She opened it and found a brand new bathroom scale. Bob has been missing since Friday. Number 4, a lady comes home from her doctor's appointment grinning from ear to ear. Her husband asks, "Why are you so happy?" The wife says, "The doctor told me that for a 45-year-old woman, I have the breasts of an 18-year-old. "Oh yeah," quipped her husband. "What did he say about your 45-year-old? She said, "Your name never came up in the conversation." Number 5, a wife comes home late one night and quietly opens the door to her bedroom. From under the blanket, she sees 4 legs instead of just her husband's 2. She reaches for a baseball bat and starts hitting the blanket as hard as she can. Once she's done, she goes to the kitchen to have a drink. As she enters, she sees her husband there, reading a magazine. He says, "Hi darling, your parents have come to visit us, so I let them stay in our bedroom. Did you say hello?" Number 6, a husband exclaims to his wife one day, "Your is getting really big. It's bigger than the barbecue grill." Later that night in bed, the husband makes some advances towards his wife, who completely brushes him off. "What's wrong?" he asks. She answers, "Do you really think I'm going to fire up this big grill for one little weenie?" Number 7, Ralph is driving home one evening when he suddenly realizes that it's his daughter's birthday and he hasn't bought her a present. He drives to the mall, runs to the toy store, and says to the shop assistant, "How much is that Barbie in the window?" In a condescending manner, she says, "Which Barbie?" She continues, "We have Barbie goes to the gym for $19.95. Barbie goes to the ball for $19.95. Barbie goes shopping for $19.95. Barbie goes to the beach for $19.95. Barbie goes nightclubbing for $19.95. And divorced Barbie for $265. Ralph asks, "Why is the divorced Barbie $265 when all the others are only $19.95? "That's obvious," the sales lady says. "Divorced Barbie comes with Ken's house, Ken's car, Ken's boat, Ken's furniture." Number 8, a police officer attempts to stop a car for speeding, and the guy gradually increases his speed until he's topping 100 miles per hour. The man eventually realizes he can't escape and finally pulls over. The cop approaches the car and says, "It's been a long day and my shift is almost over. So if you can give me a good excuse for your behavior, I'll let you go." The guy thinks for a few seconds and then says, "My wife ran away with a cop about a week ago. I thought you might be that officer trying to give her back." Number 9, after Brian proposed to Jill, his father took him to one side. "Son, when I first got married to your mother, the first thing I did when we got home was take off my pants. I gave them to your mother and told her to try them on, which she did. They were huge on her, and she said that she couldn't wear them because they were too large. I said to her, 'Of course they are too big for you. I wear the pants in this family, and I always will.' Ever since that day, son, we have never had a single problem." Brian took his dad's advice and did the same thing to his wife on his wedding night. Then, Jill took off her panties and gave them to Brian. "Try these on," she said. Brian went along with it and tried them on, but they were far too small. "What's the point of this? I can't get into your panties," said Brian. "Exactly," Jill replied, "and if you don't change your attitude, you never will." Number 10, a child asked his father, "How were people born?" So his father said, "Adam and Eve made babies. Then their babies became adults and made babies, and so on." The child then went to his mother, asked her the same question, and she told him, "We were monkeys, then we evolved to become like we are now." The child ran back to his father and said, "You lied to me." His father replied, "No, your mom was talking about her side of the family." Number 11, a couple are rushing into the hospital because the wife is going into labor. As they walk, a doctor says to them that he has invented a machine that splits the pain between the mother and father. They agree to it and are led into a room where they get hooked up to the machine. The doctor starts it off at 20% split towards the father. The wife says, "Oh, that's actually better." The husband says he can't feel anything. Then the doctor turns it to 50%, and the wife says that it doesn't hurt nearly as much. The husband says he still can't feel anything. The doctor, now encouraged, turns it up to 100%. The husband still can't feel anything, and the wife is really happy because there is now no pain for her. The baby is born. The couple go home and find the postman groaning in pain on the doorstep. Number 12, a man approached a very beautiful woman in a large supermarket and said, "I've lost my wife here in the supermarket. Can you talk to me for a couple of minutes?" "Why do you want to talk to me?" she asked, puzzled. "Because every time I talk to a beautiful woman, my wife appears out of nowhere." Number 13, a man and a woman are sleeping together when suddenly there is a noise in the house, and the woman rolls over and says, "It's my husband, you have to leave." The man jumps out of bed, jumps through the window, crawls through the bushes and out on the street when he realizes something. He goes back to the house and says to the woman, "Wait, I'm your husband." She replies, giving him a dirty look, "So why did you run?" Number 14, an explorer goes into an undiscovered tomb for the first time, and in the center of the tomb, there's a lamp. He picks it up, and as he starts to rub the dirt off of it, a genie comes out of the lamp and says, "I want to know the person you hate the most." The explorer says, "That's got to be my ex-wife." "Why?" "I am a cursed genie. I will grant you 3 wishes. But whatever you wish for, your ex-wife will get double that amount. Okay? I wish for $1 billion. Granted, but you ex-wife gets $2 billion. I wish for a mansion in California with a swimming pool and tennis courts, everything. Granted. And your ex-wife gets two? Now make your final wish." The explorer walks around for a few minutes, returns to the genie with a stick, and says, "You see this stick? I'd like you to beat me half to death." Number 15, man. "Wanna hear a joke about my penis?" "Oh, never mind, it's too long." Woman. "Wanna hear a joke about my vagina?" "Never mind, you'll never get it." Number 16, a husband, who has 6 children, begins to call his wife mother of 6, rather than by her first name. The wife, amused at first, chuckles. A few years down the road, the wife has grown tired of this. "Mother of 6," he would say, "what's for dinner tonight? Get me a beer." She gets very frustrated. Finally, while attending a party with her husband, he jokingly yells out, "Mother of 6, I think it's time to go." The wife immediately shouts back, "I'll be right with you, father of 4. Number 17, a lady goes to the doctor and complains that her husband is losing interest in sex. The doctor gives her a pill, but warns her that it's still experimental. He tells her to slip it into his mashed potatoes at dinner, so that night, she does just that. About a week later, she's back at the doctor, where she says, "Doc, the pill worked great. I put it in the potatoes like you said." It wasn't 5 minutes later that he jumped up, raked all the food and dishes onto the floor, grabbed me, ripped all my clothes off, and ravaged me right there on the table. The doctor says, "I'm sorry, we didn't realize the pill was that strong. The foundation will be glad to pay for any damages." "Nah," she says, "that's okay. We're never going back to that restaurant anyway." Number 18, during the wedding rehearsal, the groom approaches the pastor with an unusual offer. "Look, I'll give you $100 if you'll change the wedding vows. When you get to the part where I'm supposed to promise to love, honor, and obey, and be faithful to her forever, I'd appreciate it if you'd just leave that out." He passes the minister a $100 bill and walks away satisfied. On the day of the wedding, when it comes time for the groom's vows, the pastor looks the young man in the eye and says, "Will you promise to prostrate yourself before her, obey her every command and wish, serve her breakfast in bed every morning of your life, and swear eternally before God and your lovely wife that you will not ever even look at another woman, as long as you both shall live?" The groom gulps, looks around, and says in a tiny voice, "Yes," then leans toward the pastor and hisses, "I thought we had a deal." The pastor puts a $100 bill into the groom's hand and whispers, "She made me a better offer." Number 19, Stan is seconds away from receiving a vasectomy when his brother and sister-in-law barge in holding their newborn baby. "Stop. You can't do this," exclaims the brother. And why not? Asked Stan. Don't you want to have a beautiful baby someday? Like my wife and I have here? Stan says nothing. The brother grows impatient. Come on, Stan, I want a nephew. Stan, make me an uncle. Stan can't take it anymore. He gives his sister-in-law an apologetic look and asks his brother, You sure you want a nephew? Yes, the brother replies. It would be an honor. Well, congratulations, you're holding him.